out to dry moon in the background. Out to dry full moon in the background, better yet. Art lessons from the hood. Just want to remind people that my art education is my complete art education is a high school diploma. And I make these videos for sake of knowledge and capitalism. I know that there are people out there that probably didn't have access to certain role models or positive people or instruction, who want to pursue a career or a profession of creativity. So maybe you ended up here on this channel. Maybe it was just random searching. And I can give you a pointers as to how to press on this yellow prism pencil. What does the is it canary? Yeah, I think it's a canary yellow. And crystal paper, sizes of cylinders and circles and cubes and all that. But I think what the best insight I could offer is draw. Just draw. You will find your own style in there as you sketch, as you put in the hours. I'm choosing to color in the moon this way because I saw one of the posters from Nightmare Before Christmas. It had the moon looked like almost like a burnt egg from a burnt fried egg from the edges. So I'm thinking going darker from the edges of the moon, dark yellow. All right, pressed on yellow to a slightly faded or dissolved yellow into the center. just keep on practicing. Draw other people's work. Draw people's work who's you admire. Unlike the even my favorite character from Tim Burton so far has been Beetlejuice, because that story it makes no goddamn sense. You know, how the hell did he end up that way? It's no, that's a story that's out there, like, that goes with the most. And the artwork is different. It's a bit macabre, but not too scary. And I think that's what confused me as a kid a bit, when I saw basically a ghost movie, a haunting ghost story movie that, didn't frighten me. A bit creepy, but nothing like a Freddy Krueger movie or something else supernatural shown on film. I've said it over and over, and I keep on saying it. Take your time with these pieces. Your name, your reputation, that brand you're building. It's all on this moment. There's a piece of plastic somewhere hanging on my desk that's rattling either in the wind from the fan or it's moving when I put my weight on this desk. I can barely hear it. I like to sharpen my points, you know, with a black pencil in areas like this that don't, I just basically fill in. You can also use this is black, I don't mind throwing in yellow in there from the stump. It's okay. I think the black will overpower it. on the last video that I posted, I caught myself thinking of what I was saying, the way that like a politician would, when I couldn't recall clearly a story on a tattoo client that asked me for a stupid design, comparing it to poor choices, creativity, and when people ask me for feedback. Sometimes I do want to be politically correct when someone has got like maybe a golden heart and wants some insight, but you've got to put them down very slowly. Make sure you rub that black in there so it doesn't smear in other places. So yeah, I thought, seeing all these candidates of Trump, Bernie, Jill Stein, and that scumbag Hillary Clinton reminds me to be consistent and also be, I've got to admit that I fuck up sometimes. And sometimes I'll make, I will say wrong things, and I've got to admit when I'm wrong or when someone corrects me. Maybe I'm just overthinking this too much in this drawing video. Another thing that that I do wonder about is how much further will this video exist for? It's the year 2016. Just because of some Marvel comic books, I wonder if this video will last and be viewed up to the year 2099. And what sort of world would that be? But even then, I also wonder, what life would have been like from the people that were living during the roaring 20s here in America. And here, currently in the city of Los Angeles. For now. When I went to go out and eat the other day, I thought, man, so many homeless, so many fucking homeless. And some people could be like, why the fuck you call them fucking homeless? So I think for too long we've been politically pacified, correct. Not admit that it's possible that it was bad parenting, possible the dangers of alcohol, possible to the dangers of drug use, of many factors that made these people become, or genetic factors, some sort of mental disease. He just didn't end up overnight. You know, when did we stop caring for our brothers, our sisters, our child, our neighbors? And I think the most effective way for me to do it today in 2016 is spilling my guts and sharing my skill on this channel here. Because if I did it the Marine Corps way, I probably would be slapping you around, what the fuck's wrong with you, and well, if you fuck up, you'd be on fire watch. You'd be police calling the deserts, looking for uneven rocks. You'd be mowing the lawn with scissors. If you wanna act stupid, well then you're gonna keep on doing that stupid shit. But you'd be surprised how much that fixes people. Yeah, they'll hate you for it, but you know, looking at a lot of that stuff now, you think, man, I deserve this or that. I was being a little shit back when you. Because I think the Marine Corps unfucks. Fucking rebuilds a lot of shit that poor parenting created. Neglected parenting, selfish parenting, clueless parenting did. And in some cases, these people that were overlooked, just forgotten, abandoned, just ended up homeless as a result of following just stupid patterns from stupid behavior. So, yeah, do your best not to end up homeless. Does that mean, whatever your skill is, your trade, your hobby, fucking practice it daily. Improve it, improve on it. Even this here, my little $1.35 for a 2-pack. The dollar store. Pencil sharpener. Pinch my pennies, man. Pinch them. I've seen people buy $20 pencil sharpeners. Not expensive shit, just overpriced shit. Shit that you'll throw away. Because I'm pretty sure that those pencil sharpeners dull as much on wool dough as much as mine from the dollar store. Pinch your pennies, and if you're loaded watching this in 2016, well, I'll send you one of my originals for you. Negotiable price that will help me out. Help me draw more stuff if you want. Because yeah, it's a fucking circus here in 2016. And we got the candidate who says to vote for her, she's a female. To me, that's sexist, pointless, and stupid. And I would never hire a person just because they are female, just because of that. Maybe if I was opening up a strip club, you know, of course I would go with a female, but I wouldn't hire someone because he says, you should hire me because I'm a female. I think she's cold-hearted. Hillary Clinton is a scumbag. But with all these supervillains out there, you know, what can we do? We can work on ourselves, we can work on our craft. There's always room for improvement somewhere, so find it, make it happen. This video is about to cut out some too. So excuse the abrupt ending if it happens. The battery's running low on the phone. again here with this point here. Just draw flat with it. Flat with it so that way you can get a pretty sharp edge on it. Drawing with it later on. Keep on forgetting to put the link to my Kickstarter project for my Frankenstein prints in the description. So I better start doing that. Again, this is a piece of Botticelli, I believe. Dr. Finkelstein, I believe. Finkelstein on the right. And I drew Jack and the Mummy on there. Remember, I recommend joining deviantart.com because you can post up your artwork on there and you won't get banned like on Facebook or Twitter. Right. So support the guys that don't limit freedom of ideas.